And I think important before in framing the rest of my comments is the work that we do at the Atlantic Council on our U.S.-Colombia task force that Roger is a member of. This is a task force that seeks to broaden, deepen the bilateral relationship. It's chaired, it's everything we do in a bipartisan basis by Senator Roy Blunt of Missouri and Senator Ben Cardin of Maryland. And what we've essentially been doing is creating a modernized, a new plan for what a modern relationship could be between the U.S. and Colombia, building on all the great work, as Roger was mentioning, with regard to Plan Colombia. So let me just take a few moments and walk you through a little bit on the political and economic context in Colombia. And starting off with this, if you could go to the next slide, Roger was talking about 1999, about the formation of Plan Colombia, and this is Colombia in 1999. Colombia at that point was a country where you had massive displacement, kidnappings, extortions, violent conflict. These are the pictures you see top left. That's a slum in Medellin, which is once the murder capital of the world, but it's now a major hub in innovation in Latin America. The photo you see in the bottom left, I believe that should be for you, is a politician named Oscar Tulio Lizcano. And what he's doing there is he's giving proof of life. He was kidnapped in the year 2000, held for 8 years by the FARC before escaping captivity. So this is the Colombia of 1999, a Colombia where there was many concerns about a country in our own hemisphere that was on the verge of becoming a failed state. But if you go to the next slide, let's look at Colombia today. Colombia today is a very different country. It's a totally different country than it was 20 years ago. It's a country that has an incredibly improved security situation. It's a country where homicides have fallen by 50%, kidnappings by 90%, poverty's declined by 50%, and also a country where Colombia has really opened its borders, open to its economy, to promoting trade, investment, growth. Looking at across the region, Colombia's economy was the only one in Latin America that grew over 3% last year. And you see that. You see a photo from 1999 as a slum in Medellin. Looking ahead to today, you see the top right corner. That's, if you haven't been, I recommend everybody, and I don't work for the Colombian Tourism Bureau, but I recommend everybody go to Cartagena, which is an incredible destination for tourists all around the world. You also see a picture of the signing of the peace agreement, and in the middle, one of Colombia's many exports. Many of you probably bought on Valentine's Day Colombian roses. Since the 90s, flowers have become Colombia's one of Colombia's biggest exports products, shipping over about $1.5 billion in cut flowers every year. If you go to the next slide, Colombia today, looking ahead to 2022, is a country, I think, of many opportunities. Colombia is right now a country where we have the peace agreement was signed in 2016. Of course, a number of challenges. I'll get into the challenge with the peace agreement, but the opportunity that after decades of constant conflict, that an agreement was signed, and it's an agreement that puts an end to over 50 years of internal conflict in Colombia. Again, many challenges with regard to implementation, but that's an opportunity, and also an incredibly improved security situation. As Roger was talking about as well, and some of the numbers I put forward about the reductions in violence, homicides, kidnappings. If you go to the next slide, another opportunity in Colombia today as well is is the trade promotion agreement with the United States. Go back one slide, please. Go back one slide. Trade promotion agreement with the United States. The trade promotion agreement entered in force and about 8 years ago. You have 80% of U.S. consumer industrial.